Our correspondent Brett Mason reporting there. Federal MPs will report back today on nationwide support for gay marriage in Australia. The issue is being debated once again in December around the Labor Party conference. But today's developments come after a scathing attack on MP Bob Katter's controversial views on the matter from his gay brother. Joining us now with the details from Canberra is our political reporter Matt Moran. Matt, last night the Australian Prime Minister formally met with advocates for marriage equality, reportedly for the first time.
Yes, Julie Gillard had a private meeting. Among them was former AMA President Karen Phelps. She hopes the Prime Minister's views will evolve. Let's have a listen to what she had to say.
If our politicians are actually representing the views of our community, they will support marriage equality, because at least 60% of our community support marriage equality and over 50% of Christians support marriage equality. So it is no longer a religious issue. It is no longer purely a political issue. This is an issue of human rights.
Now, Carl Katter has spoken out about his half-brother's views on gay marriage. Let's have a listen to what Carl had to say.
It's hurtful, it's dangerous, it's damaging, and it's really inappropriate. It doesn't give any support to his argument by perpetuating hate and discrimination.
Is that the way you see it, the perpetuation of hate?
That's what I see it. He doesn't seem to represent the whole of his community, and he denies a lot of the fact that there are a lot of gay people in his community.
Why do you think that's so? I know you. Do you talk to him much?
Honestly, I don't. And I really don't want to talk about him that much, actually,
George. But you can see why I need to.
Oh, yeah, I can understand. But the issue here is about equality for all. And, you know, people may assume that we've made some leaps in regards to equality for gay people. But we haven't, really.
But why do you think Bob has the view that he has? We know that he's an unabashed conservative, almost ferociously so. His ideology is as clear as day.
I'm not sure. I don't understand his motives. Fundamentally, I don't know how he can target a minority and persecute them in the way he has. He's gross generalisations, etc., are just inappropriate in today's society. I mean, I can't believe I'm here today in 2011 actually talking about this.